Racist Saints sent fans into rage with what they brought on field for cop-hating thug who killed officer. Over the past several weeks, kneeling athletes within the NFL have been slapped with the brutal reality that Americans have far better ways to spend their time other than be bombarded with these nasty anti-American displays on the football field. Plummeting ratings along with nearly empty stadiums are spelling disaster for the National Felons League, with the NFL standing to lose billions in profits if this declining trajectory remains steady throughout the rest of the season. Just when we think things couldn't get more nasty, the New Orleans Saints have upped the ante of despicable behavior after the sickening thing they decided to do to a murdered cop on the football field. We've witnessed protests over the past month morph into something racist and vile. No longer are these athletes satisfied with quietly sitting or kneeling while the anthem plays. It's now common to witness black players rendering black power salutes after they tackle white players on the field. White Raiders quarterback Derek Carr had his back broken several weeks ago, where some sports commentators are speculating that Carr's all-black offensive line refused to block for him, a savage punishment to Carr for choosing to stand for the national anthem while they all sat before the game. But just when we thought things couldn't get more racist and vile, players with the New Orleans Saints just proved us all wrong. Before the game on Sunday, game officials decided to hold a special tribute to murdered New Orleans officer Marcus McNeil with a moment of silence in which everyone was supposed to participate. Officer McNeil was brutally shot down by thugs after being ambushed and murdered in cold blood on Friday morning. But cop haters on the Saints team had an entirely different idea in mind. Rather than honoring the police officer who had been brutally killed in the line of duty, several players decided to hijack the moment of silence and find a way to mock the fallen police officer's ultimate sacrifice by kneeling during the tribute. Fans were immediately outraged, and all around the stadium boos could be heard as the players knelt during the moment of silence for Officer McNeil. Blue Lives Matter reported. New Orleans, Louisiana, New Orleans Saints players kneeled before the game on Sunday, but it wasn't during the national anthem. It was during a tribute to murdered New Orleans PD officer Marcus McNeil. Fans booed as players knelt during the moment of silence for Officer McNeil. New Orleans Police Department Officer Marcus McNeil, 29, was ambushed and murdered early Friday morning. The incident happened just after midnight when a group of three officers on patrol spotted something suspicious. Officer McNeil stepped out of his car to investigate and a gunman opened fire, shooting the officer repeatedly. Other officers returned fire, shooting the suspect, who then ran into an apartment. The gunman remained barricaded in the apartment until he eventually surrendered to a SWAT team. Officer McNeil was transported to the hospital where he was pronounced dead. Officer Marcus McNeil leaves behind his wife, Brittany, and two small children. Brittany told New Orleans Magazine that Officer McNeil had always wanted to join New Orleans PD because he wanted to make a difference in the city, which is plagued with crime and poverty. This isn't the first time these protesting athletes have given their outraged fans the giant middle finger before a game. Immediately after the Las Vegas shooting 2 weeks ago, Kansas City Chiefs cornerback Marcus Peters proved he wasn't going to let the massacre of 59 Americans interfere with his protest and callously chose to sit on his butt while the national anthem played, igniting fury across the stadium. Noticing fans' displeasure for his choice to sit for the national anthem, Peters was caught screaming at a fan where he yelled "F.U.B.," before slamming his helmet onto the ground like a petulant spoiled child. The incident was aired live on ESPN, and millions tuning in immediately caught Peters' sickening message to all NFL fans offended by his anti-American antics. It's truly startling how the NFL has been transformed into a platform for these oppressed millionaires to spew their anti-American rhetoric, but even more startling how their protests are transforming into personal attack towards white players and fallen police officers. The lines are clearly being drawn in this country. And you can choose to support these anti-American racist athletes, or you can be on the side of Team America. But if you choose to support the NFL, just remember that you're supporting athletes who disrespect our cops and soldiers, and you are putting money straight into the pocket of an organization that allows disgusting acts of racism towards whites to continue on the football field.